So really funny story, you know. I get an email from Andy Stumpf, and he writes me and said, "Hey man, Don Hasselbeck from Reebok wants to come. He's gonna be in town. He's gonna be in town visiting his family. He wants to come see your gym." Well, I'm not the sharpest tool in the shed. You know, I don't put two things together really fast. I'm not a quick-witted guy. So I'm like, "Yeah, cool. Come on by." So we're sitting here one day, and I kind of forgot about it, you know. And all of a sudden, in walks this giant. And I mean, I have double extra large hands, and his hands completely engulf my hand. I'm like, holy crap, he's got this big, massive ring on there. I'm like, "Hey, what's up, man? I'm really, you know, haha." He's got these two really beautiful blonde ladies with him. He's like, "This is my wife, and this is my daughter-in-law." Right on, and we start talking. The company I used to work for, the company I work for, the owner of that company also owns the Seahawks. And I'm like, "Yeah, I used to work for this company." He's like, "Oh, so does her husband." And I'm like, "Oh, cool, what department?" She's like, "The team." I'm like, "Oh yeah, what department?" She's like, "The quarterback." And I'm like, "You know, I'm just not that fast." And I'm like, Hasselbeck? I'm like, "Are you talking about Matt Hasselbeck?" She's like, "Yeah, he's my husband." And I'm like, and my wife looks at me, and she's like, my wife just shakes her head. I'm like, "Oh, I feel like a moron right now, you know?"
So my first real like hit home experience with CrossFit, my brother Tim, who used to play in the NFL, who now is a commentator on ESPN, came out to visit us, and we have a swimming pool, took his shirt off, and my kids were like, "Whoa, what happened to Tim?" And my oldest daughter was like, "Daddy, you should do that," you know? And he was just chiseled, he was ripped. I mean, he's always been in shape, but I mean, like really, really chiseled, like ridiculous. And you know, I was like, "What are you doing?" Like, "Dude, I'm doing CrossFit. I've done it all. I'm doing CrossFit. It's amazing. It's so hard. It's so awesome." And you know, he just loved it. So that was really okay.
You know, me and Don got along pretty good. You know, we had a good time, and he just kept telling me, he's like, "You know, Tim does CrossFit. Tim is his other son. Tim also played in the NFL. He's like, Tim does CrossFit. He loves it. You know, I just started doing it. I love it."
My dad, he like, you know, he's got all these old injuries, and doctors told him, "Oh, don't do this, don't do that, don't do this." And somebody from CrossFit was like, "Hey, you're 55. Where do you think you're going to be at 65? And so I think that scared him a little bit, and he got working, and he lives in Boston. I live in Seattle, so I hadn't seen him for like 4 months, and then I saw him, and I was like, "What the heck happened to you, you know? You look like me, you know?" And then I got like, "Oh, okay, I need to step up my game."
And I want to get Matt in here. And it's, you know, I was like, "Yeah, I would love to have the guy. I'd love to have Matt in here too." And it was kind of like, you know, you want to say, "Yeah, can I meet him?" But at the same time, you're like, you know, he probably gets that all the time. You know, you don't want to be that guy. And I didn't want to be that guy, you know?
So finally, like, my dad was like, "Hey, just do 20 sessions. And I'm like, "Ah, 20 sessions, that's less than 3 weeks." Well, not exactly. And if you start out going like Monday, Wednesday, Friday, so I'm roped in, I'm stuck.
Andy sends me another email about almost 2 months ago and says, "Hey, Reebok's starting an initiative. We wanna have sponsored athletes, a way for them to go to CrossFit gyms." And I was like, "Okay, cool." She's like, "Yeah, I want, basically we want you to do 20 sessions with Matt Hasselbeck, and we want an honest opinion of what he does. We have a program for you to follow. Can you follow it, and can you push him? Can you see what he's got?" I'm like, "Yeah, sure, no problem, you know?"
You know, with this lockout, it's been a challenge to work out, and you're used to on your team getting world-class coaching and world-class training, you know, with strength coaches and all that kind of stuff, and a weight room and that kind of thing. And I think most of us, you know, this is my 13th year in the NFL, going on 14, I think. And you know, I'm just used to having that kind of coaching and that kind of facility. And you know, you go into some random gym, and it's just like you get on an elliptical and you bench and you do some pull down. It's just not what you're used to and not what you need. And so I had an opportunity through people I know, and you know, basically to learn about CrossFit, and they were like, "Hey, Dan Cerrillo from CrossFit Bellevue is like in your backyard. It's a shame if you don't go and train there." And so I said, "All right, I'll try it. You know, I'll try it. I'll give you 20 workouts."
And so we talked on the phone. Matt called me up, and we talked on the phone, I don't know, maybe an hour, you know, just kind of chatted. He was really skeptical, you know, like, "I don't know about this. I'm not sure. You know, here's what I kind of do." And it's really hard for me to go, don't do that.
But I knew right away from talking to Dan, the way we communicated, that it was gonna be hard, but it was gonna be really good. And it's just, it's the thing I didn't know is how much of this stuff will really help me in a season.
So I'm like, hey, I'll tell you what, come in one day. If I can't show you a little bit of a difference in one day, then maybe we're not as great as we say we are. You know, I'll be like, just give me a chance. Give me one day. If you like it, give me 1 week. I go, we'll just go from there, you know?
I think another thing that got me kind of, you know, on the Reebok side, so Reebok was like, hey, you know, this CrossFit thing, we're all about it now. You know, we want our NFL guys that wear our shoes, wear our stuff, you know, to try it out. And it was kind of like, wow, okay, I don't know. And then they're like, hey, No. Sean Marino's doing it, Chris Cooley's doing it, Brandon Marshall's doing it. And it's kind of like, all right, okay, those guys are doing it, you know. And then, like, you see some of those guys, and, you know, you see, like, whoever, like Brandon Marshall, like, hey, you try the CrossFit thing? And they're like, did I, you know? And so it's like a, you know, it's a good thing. Guys you know are unbelievable athletes, like unbelievable, best in the world at what they do. Getting broke down the same way, you're like, okay, I feel good about that.
And I came in, they gave me a guideline, the first workout I wanted to do, I want you to do 10 minutes of Cindy. And here I am going, 10 minutes of Cindy? I'm like, well, what else do I do, you know? What's this shit, you know? I'm like, all right, I'll do 10 minutes of Cindy. I'm like, okay, we'll start with Cindy and then we'll go on and do some real training. So I set up, you know, whatever, the other thing that I wanted him to do. And we go and we do our warm up. We do a pretty long warm up routine. We go into Cindy and it wasn't what I expected. To be nice about it, he was not doing well.
I think my first workout here was a Cindy, maybe, or like my first Cindy hurt me. I didn't think it would. It killed me.
Yeah, I wish I, you know, if I would have been smart, I would have videotaped the first day he came in here, but I don't think he would ever want to watch it, you know. I think our session was probably like 40 minutes long, and it was more of me like, oh shit, I hope I don't kill him, you know. I really expected, you know, here's an NFL quarterback, for him to come in and literally laugh. Like, you want me to do 10 minutes of this workout? And he was dying. He was crushed. And he was obliterated. Like, to the point where I was like, shit, I don't know if we're gonna make it 10 minutes. I mean, I was really worried. Like, man, I hope I don't hurt the Seahawks quarterback, you know? Like, cool. And I'm sitting there like, is it that hard? I haven't done 10 minutes ever. I've always done 20 minutes. And it's always hard then, you know?
Sad thing is, I thought I was in shape when I came in.
So we get done with the workout, and he's done, man. He's done. And so I'm kind of looking at all the equipment I had set out. He's like, are we doing anything else? I'm like, no, we're not. So I'm like, what I want to do now is, now that you're tired, I want to do a little test with you. And it's just a gymnastics test of kind of seeing where his core strength was. Put him up in the rings, and yeah, it was bad. You know, his shoulders, everything hurt him. Everything that I did with him hurt him.
All right, tuck. Good. 26. Let me see. When we first started, it was like 2. So we're getting there. We're getting there.
When I first got on the rowing machine, like, I own one of those rowing machines, but I could never get on it because I don't know, just like doing exercises where I was sitting kind of made my back feel kind of stiff. I don't know, like, how is that going to help me? And Dan was like, no, this is like a deal breaker. You got to do it. You're tough. You got to do it. And then getting on the rings, I had a broken wrist. I mean, I had 2 broken bones. I'm like, listen, I just can't have surgery. I'm just trying to avoid a surgery here. I got this big brace on. He's like, all right, well, just do what you can, you know? And like, you know, that, the GHD machine, I'm like, yeah, I just can't do it. You know, it was kind of got into a thing where like, hey, I can't do it. That was something I would say. And he kind of gave me this look like, you can't or you won't. I was like, okay, fine. I'll do something, you know? So I think there were moments like that, or even just when the first day I walked in, everyone's on these rings, you know, doing like the, I don't even know, just like looking like their shoulders, like my shoulders were hurting watching them. And Dan's like, oh yeah, you'll be doing those soon. I'm like, no, I won't. Sure enough, here I am, you know?
Like I told my wife, this is a validation of everything that I've done. To not the fact that he walked in the door, the fact that somebody trusts me enough to do it. I take that to heart, you know. For his father to say, I don't want him training at any other CrossFit gym, I want him training with you. That's a big compliment for me, you know, because I know how I am with my kids. You know, I'm very protective of my kids, so that I can't explain how much of a compliment that was to me, you know. And here's an athlete who gets paid a lot of money to perform 16 times a year. If he doesn't perform, he doesn't get that money again. And if it's as a result of me, then, you know, so yeah, I feel pretty good about it. It's a great honor, and it's something I don't take lightly, you know. So
I think my experiences here at CrossFit Bellevue have been, you know, I came in not really knowing what to expect, a little nervous, like, am I gonna get hurt? You know, this is a little crazy. People are nuts here, but I've bought in. I love it. I'm in. I feel so much stronger than when I started. I feel ready for the NFL season to come. I'm excited to see my teammates. We've been locked out and I haven't seen them. I'm excited to see those guys because they'll be able to tell, my coaches will be able to tell that, you know, I've been busting my butt this offseason, and it's just a good feeling to know that you put the work in, you've got money in the bank, and you're ready to cash in from all those workouts, all those tough workouts that you didn't think you could survive. You survived and you made it, and you know, you've got something to show for it.